So here we are on the lower Wikipimi River in Woodbury, checking up on the knobfin sculpin population, which has taken hold here in the past 10 years or so, 15 years. They seem to be as abundant as ever. And it's a bit of an interesting story about how we discovered them and the history of the population here. I'm a fisheries biologist. I've been with the DEP for 31 years now, and been involved with the stream survey for most of that time, as well as trout management in our trout streams. And I've sampled in this stream since 1990, and we got the first sculpin out of this whole watershed in 2002. A single individual right at this site. And it was a very long sample, so they were very rare. We found one. We took pictures of it. It was an anomaly. We assumed that it was a slimy sculpin because that was the only species of sculpin that we knew occurred in the state. So for about 10 years after that, I continued to sample every year, and primarily looking at the trout population, survival of stocked brown trout fry. But not every year, but every once in a while, we would get another individual sculpin, and it would be really cool. Hey, look at this, we got another sculpin. In about 2012, we noticed a big bump up in the abundance of sculpins. It's like, well, we used to get one once in a while. This year we got 25, and then the next year would be, wow, there's like 100 of them here in our sample. And then it just got out of control. There were literally thousands and thousands, we estimated, you know, maybe 10,000 in our standard sample zone. Other groups sampled as well, and everybody was calling them slimy sculpins because they look virtually identical, at least at quick glance, with slimy sculpins, our native sculpin. But it was obviously very weird. The stream is, Wikipimi River is much warmer than the typical sculpin stream. I've set thermographs here and determined that it reached up to 78 on a warm day in the summertime. And that's just not slimy sculpin friendly temperature. So that was curious. I had a seasonal who was also a student at UConn looking for a special project. And Dr. Eric Schultz had expressed an interest in sculpins throughout the state. So we kind of teamed up, Josh Tellier, Dr. Eric Schultz at UConn, and myself, to put together a study, summer study, for Josh to be the hands-on person looking at these sculpins. And we collected sculpins from about 10 different locations in the state, including extensive collection in the Wikipimi River, and also close by tributaries, the Nanawag River and Sprain Brook. And Josh very diligently on his own time examined all the sculpins very closely, and it became clear that the sculpins from the Pomperaug River drainage had different counts and different superficial coloration than what we were finding in our known native populations, mostly further north in the northwest, north central Connecticut. So another red flag, maybe these aren't slimy sculpins in the Pomperaug drainage. Dr. Schultz had connections with a lab in Greece, and he sent out both slimies from the northwest corner of Connecticut and the unknown sculpins from the Pomperaug drainage, sent them to Greece for genetic sequencing, and they came back definitively, without question, as basically not, there's a little bit more to it, but basically knobfin sculpins that are native to the Ozark region of Missouri and Arkansas. We've noticed some impacts to the native fish community. The native minnows like creek chubs, common shiners, blacknose dace, longnose dace, they seem to have been outcompeted by this new efficient predator. And part of what makes them such an efficient predator, the knobfin sculpins, is their very large mouth. They can eat things very large size, larger than most of our native minnows. So we suspect that they consume vast quantities of young of year fish, including their own. They're known to be cannibalistic. They'll scarf up their own young of year and an inch long, along with everything else that moves, including small crayfish and small trout. So it looks as though they've had an impact on trout as well. This section of river here, I've stocked with fry for a very long time, since 1997. And when the sculpins boomed, the brown trout survival just plummeted. So it's pretty clear evidence that these knobfin sculpins do have a negative impact on trout as well as other fish species and invertebrate species. And it's something that we definitely don't want getting into any of our other trout streams. The best we can do is to contain them here and just keep them from getting into our other trout streams, because this habitat looks very similar to a lot of trout streams where there's natural reproduction or sort of as nursery streams. The habitat, the temperatures are all very similar. So it seems very likely that if these fish got into another stream with similar characteristics, that they would do the same thing. They would flourish, they would dominate, they would damage the trout reproduction.